Hey everybody, I'm Christopher Green. You're watching AMTV Alternative Media Television. Please share this video virally, pun not intended, across your social media networks. I think this will be the biggest story in the world in the next few days as this progresses and this outbreak is spreading worldwide. Of course, we warned about the coronavirus, no, not the beer, the actual virus that is airborne has already infected thousands, like the Black Plague of generations past, and people are dying in the streets. In fact, if this is accurate, I'm looking at a tweet right now from Max, who says this: people are literally dying on the streets of China. 20 million people across three, now four major cities on lockdown in a complete martial law FEMA camp scenario. They are not allowed to get on trains, board airplanes. They've been alerted not to go into city centers, don't go shopping, standing in line at hospitals as people collapse and die in the streets. Now, this is spread across the globe. We had the first confirmed case in the United States just about a day ago. And of course, this has moved, I think, also in Washington state. And we are seeing this progress in not just places like Australia, parts of Asia, Singapore, Europe, now in 11 countries and more, spreading by the second at an unprecedented rate. At the same time, the World Health Organization is considering an upgrade to a level 3 threat assessment. Now, we are currently at level 2. Now, keep in mind, when we get to level 3, we're talking martial law in the United States of America. By the way, gas masks are selling out on Amazon. I checked earlier this morning. They were sold out on 9 out of 10 suppliers that I checked with. I actually ordered some more of them. You should have all this stuff on hand, by the way. I mean, why would you not prepare? I've been telling you to prepare for years now as a part of geopolitical conflict, events like this, deadly disease, potential nuclear warfare. The list goes on and on and on. Now, the WHO director just said that each country is on its own. And then they tell you, they give you the advice to wash your hands. WTF, this user says. So let's just break down the symptoms and how to diagnose if you have been infected with this deadly disease in the same family and virus strain family, from what I've read, as SARS. And then we'll get into the origin of where they think this has come from. And then I'll delve into some things that I think, well, it probably will be eye-opening for a lot of you, because this plays into not just climate change, but also the agenda of people like Bill Gates that, of course, are pro-vaccination and stand to profit in the billions and billions by providing the solution to the Black Death that has just been released to the public. Isn't that convenient? I think it'll also be harnessed and utilized as a weapon of not just psychological and physical warfare, but fear, as the mainstream media is going to pump this threat level to such a high degree, it could potentially send not just Americans here in the United States of America into a panic, and what we're already seeing all around the world, an absolute frenzy. In addition to that, Wall Street is warning. The indicators on Wall Street, Dow selling off today quite aggressively. We saw this with the SARS outbreak years ago. This could be the recipe for a total economic shutdown, so to speak, as people stop spending money, stop visiting Disneyland, stop going to the mall, because they don't want to get sick. Now, what's very, very dangerous about these symptoms and diagnosis is it's very similar to the general flu. So those getting it and dropping dead in the streets of China don't know if they just have a typical flu and those are the symptoms, or they have this brand new virulent, and what many fear, biologists fear, could be a mutating strain of Black Death. Here are the symptoms from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. I'll put a link below so you can read this for yourself in preparation of your own family if and when a quarantine is declared here in the United States in your city, state, or town, as has just been declared in China, again affecting 20 plus million people, as the Chinese are downplaying the severity, I believe, of this emergency. Now look, I don't trust governments anywhere. I especially don't trust the tyrannical government of China, the same government that beats its pro-democracy, liberty-loving protesters with American flags in Hong Kong. This is a tyrannical surveillance state regime, and that's who they are. So when they're downplaying this outbreak risk that they say might come from snakes or might come from bats or might come from farm animals and these kinds of things. If they say only 1,000 people are infected, then we know 10,000 people are infected. If they say 10,000 people are affected, which are some of the numbers coming now, that means 1 million people are infected. That means they haven't been able to contain this. And I think this could be the largest cover-up we have ever witnessed in history of AMTV, history of the internet. And again, I believe this to be a viral, not just infection, but story breaking out worldwide. Here are the common symptoms of the coronavirus, including types 229E, NL63, OC43, and HK01. Usually cause mild to moderate upper respiratory tract illnesses like the common cold. Most people get infected with these viruses at some point in their lives. These illnesses usually last for a short amount of time. Symptoms may include, so check your symptoms to see if it matches any of these: runny nose, headache, cough, sore throat, fever, a general feeling of being unwell. Now, because these general symptoms are so benign and similar to some of the other general symptom and responses of a typical person, healthy person's immune system, it's very difficult to tell who and who does not have this deadly virus. And we are seeing some pretty dramatic images right now. In fact, I'm watching something on Twitter here from Corona at Bori35, hashtag coronavirus outbreak. There's 31,000 tweets on this right now. Again, social media doesn't lie, folks. They don't make this up. It's not fake news that 20 million people are in quarantine. It's not fake news looking at these images with your own eyes, people dropping dead in the streets, people wearing and selling out gas masks in Wuhan. Now, here we have, this is from somebody who has a relative in Wuhan, one of the 5 hospitals waiting in line to get checked, where we see the masses here. And I don't know if this is a smart idea. I don't think it is, folks. Why would you go to the hospital unless you were already sick, only to increase your chances of actually contracting the contagious, deadly disease? Now, keep in mind, Bill Gates has warned for a very long time, these are not my words, that he thinks a coming virulent disease and outbreak could kill 30 plus million people within 6 months, and says we should prepare for it as we do for war. Here we have an image of Bill Gates, who has also invested billions of dollars into vaccination programs and vaccine type related awareness, and companies that stand to profit, follow the money in the billions of dollars, by providing the solution to the Black Death. Now, there is some speculation, this is to be confirmed, and I will tell you that when it's just speculation, that a Chinese lab that studies the, quote, world's most dangerous pathogens is based in Wuhan. And potentially, they could have let this virus out on accident, or, call me a conspiracy theorist, maybe intentionally. Now, of course, governments around the world have done this before, where they willfully inject syphilis, in one example, with the Tuskegee example here in the United States of America in the 1930s, where they actually rounded up a bunch of Black African-American men here in the United States, injected them with syphilis so they could study the virulent, damaging, and deforming effects of that disease. We've seen this with many different government CIA-led operations. We saw this in the 1970s, and we certainly saw it with the Tuskegee experiment. Now, this has all been declassified. This is all hardcore facts, and you need to wake up to this. I have a corroborating article, another one here. Bill Gates funds seawater cloud seeding, chemtrails, the most benign form of geoengineering. Chemtrails used to be a conspiracy. You know, the trails that the airplanes, the government planes only, not the Boeing 747s and commercial jets. You'll notice this. When they're at similar altitudes, the same part of day, we watch them here in Arizona all the time. I take video and photographs all the time. You'll have 2-3 different planes in the sky, same altitude, during the same day, at the same time, but only the government planes will be spraying barium, bromide, other cancerous, toxic chemicals as they spray you like a bug. Now, people they ask, where does this stuff come from? Why are people getting sick? Why do they have respiratory illnesses? Now, this is what the elites tell you why they're doing this. They say that they're attempting to block out UV-related sunlight so that it plays into the whole global warming, protect the earth, make sure that the ice caps don't melt theory, which is all it is, a theory. We've been having ice ages for thousands and thousands of years, pre-carbon emissions, pre-Lear jets, pre-cars, pre-automobiles, pre-7 billion plus population. We had ice ages then, and we'll certainly have ice ages again, which is exactly why they've changed the semantics of the term global warming to climate change, because we're not warming, we're actually cooling. In fact, we're shivering here in Arizona, in Scottsdale right now, while they admit that they're geoengineering our skies. Now, here's an article from Bill Gates. It's actually from a while ago, because it's been going on for years, from 2010. Bill Gates funds seawater cloud seeding, the most benign form of geoengineering. He's getting very serious about it. Back in January, after the failure of governments at the Copenhagen Climate Change Summit to do anything serious, the billionaire former head of Microsoft announced he's giving nearly $5 million of his fortune to fund research into geoengineering projects. Recently announced his first concrete foray into the field, giving $300,000 to project to the project that would spray seawater into the sky. Now, there's this method. There's also the method of spraying chemicals by government planes to cover in a milky goo the blue, beautiful sky. And that's why you're having respiratory problems. We have it here all the time. It's gotten worse in Arizona in recent years. And then they blame things like pollution and stuff coming from California. It's absolutely ridiculous. I always say this, folks. Trust your own eyes. Understand, almost like we're in a petri dish, right? Almost like we're in that movie where there's a dome top and a flat earth. They are spraying and blanketing our beautiful, amazing, godly created skies with toxic chemicals. We also have, this is breaking right now from Fox 5 News, an LAX passenger has just been quarantined. This is breaking live right now after showing potential coronavirus symptoms. So here are the facts. We have flu-like symptoms breaking out around the world. We have tens of thousands of people right now infected with this deadly SARS family-like strain. Symptoms, according to the CDC, which act much like the common flu or cold, so you don't really know if you have it. Billionaires like Bill Gates fear-mongering and warning you tuning in for years that 30-plus million people could die on the spot in less than 6 months, and we need to treat it as an act of war. Now, infected people seen dead in the streets in quarantined Chinese virus city. Here I have another corroborating report in Wuhan. Of course, the lockdown of 20 million plus people in four cities and growing has been branded a zombie land apocalypse by frantic locals after Chinese authorities told residents they are not allowed to leave yesterday morning. Pictures from inside the city paint an apocalyptic picture as medics patrol in hazmat suits and gas masks. In an upload direct from Wuhan, a man can be seen lying unresponsive on the floor as concerned individuals look on, purportedly dead. U.S. coronavirus. Washington state medics monitor 16 people who came into contact with the U.S. coronavirus patient zero, as second suspected victim is hospitalized after arriving at LAX from Mexico City. Again, my opinion, massive cover-up. You're not being told the truth. Millions of people on lockdown in China right now. A declaration, essentially, of martial law. Forced quarantine and really the equivalent of a FEMA camp in action. Airplanes being sanitized. Government workers with gas masks and running through ports of entry right now, not just into the United States, but also European nations. So here's a question. Is this an organic viral outbreak that you tuning in should take seriously? Or is it just all fake news and, you know, it's just a lie that they shut down 20 million people in China? And is this an organic outbreak that naturally occurred as a natural event? Or could it perhaps be a biochemical terror weapon? Bioweapon potentially unloaded and unleashed onto the American and global population for what the elites have told us they've always intended. Population controls. Again, this ties into climate change, taxing the air you breathe. You know, I was thinking about earlier, what a fantastic year it's been so far in 2020. We had the Iran missile attack as they launched missiles at U.S. bases in the Middle East and almost the outbreak of World War III. Now an actual viral outbreak. Australia literally burning itself to the ground right now. And not to mention, I think this is going to tie in a significant way to the U.S. stock market and economic calamity on the horizon. Again, if the dumb down propaganda ingesting Kool-Aid drinking masses cows that have been indoctrinated by the institutions around the world, educational systems, and of course the mass mind control psychedelic warfare propaganda, if this is anything what I think it potentially could be, this could be the most significant event we are laying witness to right now of biblical proportions that could only be described as an event from and really prophesized in the holy book itself. I'm Christopher Green. Please be prepared. Take this moment to share this video with your loved ones, the people that you love and care about in your communities. Post this on Facebook, rip it on YouTube and Twitter. Take action because they're going to cover up this video. They don't want the truth to get out. They're going to cover it up until millions of people are dead. Because that's how the government works, folks. They lie to you. And the mainstream media, and certainly your government, cannot be trusted. So take action today. Get these facts out to the world. And understand, this is an emergency alert brought to you by AMTV, Alternative Media Television. Hard-hitting and in your face, I'm Christopher Green. I love you, and Jesus Christ is King.